Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys a few different ways in which we can create new windows using Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Let's get started, everybody. So we're going to create a window, and we'll add a button to this window. When we click on this button, it'll create a new separate window for us. So window equals tk followed by window.main loop. We'll need to add a button, so let's do that. Button, we're adding this to the window. Let's add some text to the button. Let's say create new window. And we'll set a command. Command equals, and we'll need to define a function. Let's create a function called create underscore window. And let's pack this as well. So we will define this function, create window, and let's do so at the top. Def, create window, and what do we want this to do? Well, we're going to create a new window, and let's call this next window new underscore window equals, and there's two popular ways of creating a window. One is we can use tk, and the other is that we can use something called top level, and let me explain the difference between the two. Here's a definition for a top level window. This is a new window on top of other windows, and it's usually linked to a bottom window. Our main window is serving as the bottom window, and our new window is serving as the top window, the top level window. So let's try this and just experiment. Here is our main window, the bottom window, and if we were to click on this button, it's going to create a new window for us, a new top level window. If we were to close out of the bottom level window, any top level windows associated with this would also close, kind of like what you just saw now. However, it's not the same case the other way around. If we have a bottom window and a top level window, and we close out of the top level window, our bottom level window is just fine. It didn't close out of that. So think of these like Jenga pieces. If you were to pull one of the pieces, one of the windows, out from underneath the bottom, any pieces or windows on the top of it will close out as well, or collapse, kind of like in the game Jenga. So that's one way to think of top level windows. They're stacked on top of any bottom level windows. If you remove a bottom piece, it removes any from the top. On the flip side, we have tk. This is a new independent window, and we've actually been doing this since day one of our GUI programming. Tk is a new independent window, and our main window and the new window that we create are not linked whatsoever. They're completely independent. So if we were to create a new window, this is our new window, and close out of our old window, well, this new window still persists. So this could be useful for, let's say, a login form or a login screen. After you log in, you'll be brought to your main program, which could be within the new window. One other thing that you can do too, you can also destroy the old window after creating a new window. So we need to type in the name of the window that we want to destroy. Actually, let's call the main window just old underscore window, just to clarify things. So let's rename that here, here, and here as well. So we want to destroy our old window as if we're closing out of it. So we type in the name of the window, old underscore window, and we use the destroy function, and that sounds pretty sweet. So we're going to destroy our old window after creating our new window. So let me add a comment that this will close out of old window. And let's test it. So we have our old window, our main window. We'll create a new window. It creates our new window and then closes out of the old window. So that's one of a few ways in which you can create a new window for your program. So if you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how to create a new window using Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.